Hey traders, David Frost, LazyGapTrader.com. In this video, I'm going to show you three examples of morning gap trades that worked out picture perfect. Before we dig into the charts, let's understand exactly what this gap trading strategy is all about. As day traders, we need opportunity. In order to find opportunity, we need stocks that are moving at the opening bell. We know as day traders, our best opportunity comes within the first 60 to 90 minutes of trading. After that, the market goes into a snooze fest most of the time. We have to get our opportunities early in the morning. Stocks that are moving at the opening bell create the opportunity, but as day traders, the real opportunity is for traders that can identify the specific price levels where these stocks will first be drawn to like a magnet and then have a price reaction from in the other direction. In my course at LazyGapTrader.com, traders learn everything they need to know in order to trade the gaps successfully. What type of stocks does this work the best with? What type of volume criteria do we look for? How much profit target do we look for? What type of stop loss limitation do we need to have? Where do you find the specific stocks? How much of a gap higher or lower are we looking for? And here's the holy grail, folks. How do you identify the specific price levels where these stocks will first be drawn to like a magnet and then have that price reaction from in the other direction? Before we dig deep into the charts, I want to show you the other thing I do, which is give traders an opportunity to get my gap trade sent to them each and every morning at 9 o'clock a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 30 minutes before the market's even open for business. This morning, we had four morning gap trade opportunities on the board. Out of this specific list, two hit their target prices and two did not. We're going to go over the ones that did hit their target prices and then discuss the charts. But even so, one of the ones that missed was Momo, and it only missed by 11 cents, meaning the stock was going lower. It found a bottom 11 cents higher than our target buy price and took off to the upside. That happens. Sometimes we get filled, sometimes we don't. We take what the market gives us. We have no choice. However, let's discuss what the two stocks that did hit their target levels did, and then we'll look at the charts. The first one was COUP, gap lower, support levels are $62.82, and then I gave a secondary level down at $60.76. Stop and profit target is about 35 to 65 cents. Keep in mind, these are minimum profit targets. We'll go over more about that when we get back to the charts. The second one that hit its price target or price objective today was Carnival Cruise, CCL, gap lower, support levels are $59.06, $58.5693. Stop and profit target is about 35 to 65 cents. Again, minimum profit targets. Also keep in mind, when you see more than one price target, that means that those are separate and independent trades from one another. Those are each separate support levels from one another. We're back on the chart of COUP, so let's pick apart and understand exactly what happened. The stock closed yesterday all the way up at $68.80. So the stock is getting a haircut at the open, qualifies for one of our morning gap trades, identify a level down at $62.82. Keep in mind, any trader that's taken my course at LazyGapTrader.com is able to come up with and identify the same exact price targets you see here. You see what happened? The stock came down, hit the price objective, stayed within the stop loss limitation, it made a low of $62.33, and just minutes later was already at a high of $64.97 for more than a dollar gain from the entry in just a matter of minutes. Even a few minutes after that, the stock continued higher, making a high of $65.44. This is why I say minimum profit targets. In the course, there's an entire video module where traders learn how to take advantage of situations like this, where we can turn trades like this into risk-free, emotionless trades, enabling us to get the most profit possible out of trades like this. How about Carnival Cruise? The stock closed yesterday at $61.08. Getting a haircut at the open, the stock found a low at our level. Our price level was $59.06. As you can see, the stock made a slightly lower low down at $58.99, just 7 cents below our entry. The stock then reversed and now is continuing to the upside. The rest is, as they say, academic. Listen, folks, this is a strategy that you can use each and every day for the rest of your trading career. Here's the kicker. Once you understand the why behind the strategy, why does this work? It changes your outlook on trading because you have a different expectation of what's going to happen at these specific price targets. Once you remove the guesswork away from trading and add back in confidence, it changes your trading for good. If you want to learn everything there is to know about how to trade the gap successfully, come over to check out the course at lazygaptrader.com. I'm David Frost, Lazy Gap Trader. Thanks for tuning in, folks.